Hi, my name is Adrian. Let me show you how these two components can turn your boring rooftop tent into the tent of your dreams. That's super cool, right? Well, now let me introduce you to the two products that make this possible. These are both made by a company called Progressive Automations. And the first component is an electric linear actuator. And that's a bit of a mouthful, but basically what it is there's an electric motor at the base here, and it's connected to a shaft. And as the motor spins, the shaft either extends or retracts, and that's what allows you to open and close the lid of the rooftop tent. Connected to the back of it is a fully waterproof power cable, okay? And that connects to the second component, which is the control box. Here we can connect up to two actuators. We have control boxes that can go up to four, but in this case, we only need two for my rooftop tent. And then the third input is your 12 volt input from your car battery. On the back of the control box, there is an antenna, and that allows me to control the rooftop tent with just a wireless key fob like this. Now, everyone's going to be asking themselves, well, why would I move to an electric system when the good old gas strut has been working for years and years to open and close rooftop tents like this? And let me show you why. And this is a gas strut. So basically what it is like a piston. There's a shaft here and it has a piston on the end of it. And in this section here, there's high pressure nitrogen gas. And the gas is always trying to push this shaft out via that piston. And it's doing so with really a lot of force. And this is what has been on rooftop tents for years and years and years. Now, the main concerns why people want to move away from this is, as I said, there is a lot of force in this piston. There's no way I can overcome the force of this by hand like this. I'll need to use the mechanical advantage of the lid. And what that means is people with any sort of physical limitations or disabilities are not able to jump up on the back of that car and pull down with sufficient force to close this or overcome this gas strut. And it just means that less people can love and utilize a rooftop tent like this because we're still using the old school gas struts. Secondly, in terms of speed, the electric system is way better than the gas struts. I can now turn this normally two-person job into a one-person job and be done within 2 minutes. Normally what we have to do is one person holds the roof of the tent by the handles and pulls it down closed. And as we do that, a second person goes around and pushes all the material in as it's closing down. Now, I can do that all just with one person. I can have the remote in my hand and close that rooftop tent incrementally, stopping at any time so I can walk around the car, pushing in the material, and when I'm ready, hold down that button and the tent will close fully, ready to pack up and go. And then thirdly, these are not very robust. These gas struts are very easily damaged. It's a very thin walled tube, has high pressure nitrogen in it. There's also these seals, which are rubber at the front to make sure that water and dust and debris doesn't get in there, but also to hold the pressure of the nitrogen gas. Now, as you can imagine, if there's any damage to this, you're going to lose all ability to open and close that rooftop tent. Whereas the electric system, like the electric linear actuator from Progressive Automations, they are built super robust. They can go through mud, dirt, rainfall, through the bush, any of those kind of situations that you'll find yourself in when you really take these off-road and work day in, day out. So now what I want to do is give you a quick run around the setup and just show you how I've wired everything and how I've set it up on my tent to be as nice and compact and neat as possible. Alright, so for this section we're going handheld, so please excuse the bumpiness. But what I've done is I've made a custom enclosure here. If we go back to that control box that I showed you previously, you can see that this control box fits within that enclosure. And what that allows me to do is just run all the cables up nice and neatly in a waterproof enclosure. And it also allows me to mount a few extra components to it. So the first one I have is an isolator switch. So I can fully remove this interlock key, and now no one can use this box to open and close that lid. It cuts off all power to the whole system. Okay, and then when I'm ready to go, I can just put that key back in and turn it on, and that repowers the whole system. The next thing I have is a three-way toggle switch. If you push up, obviously the actuators will extend, and if you push down, the lid will then close. So now what you can see, we'll move on to the actuator itself. So you can see the actuator is just mounted to a piece of stainless steel. So that's 10 millimeters thick, and that is connected to the tent using the standard rails that come with the tent. Okay, so most tents will have that in order to connect their gas struts there. So basically I just removed the gas strut and used a thicker piece of material which I could bolt through the actuator onto, and that allows me to then open and close that actuator and therefore the lid. So I have another mount at the top there, and we're able to easily set up and pack up in just a few minutes. So just like that, I'm able to take a very standard off-the-shelf rooftop tent and convert it to my very own electric system, where I can just, at a push of a button, close that rooftop tent and head on down the road.